So I'm going to walk you through the setup process for the 3D printer, so you're ready to print your first design. When it arrives in your school, the first thing that you'll need to do is actually take out the hood. You can do this very easily just by taking it out through the front. Your next step will be to remove the clips that secure the belts for transport. These simply just slide off. The extruder head can now move in different directions now that the clips have been removed. Save these clips because they'll be important for when you need to send it to the next school. Your next step is to load the filament. You'll need to take the filament, which is derived from a substance called PLA, and you're going to have to thread it into the spool holder. Simply thread through the hole. And place the spool of filament into the canister. Once you've threaded the filament, just replace the canister in the back of the machine. We're now ready to set up the printer and connect it to power. At the back of the machine, there is a power point. Just connect there and plug into power. And then turn on at the back. We're now ready to load the filaments into the machine. To do that, I suggest snipping off the end of the filament so you've got a nice clean cut that will thread easily. You'll need to have the filament guide, and you just thread the filament through the tube and then place that in the end. There's a hole in the extruder head. And then we will feed the filament through. Turn the machine on by pressing the button at the front. To load the filament, you need to go to the tools option in the menu. Select filament and select load. This will start to heat up the nozzle of the extruder ready to accept the filament. It's going to get to about 220 degrees Celsius. It may take a moment for the printer to heat up. When the 3D printer has reached the required temperature, it's ready to load the filament. You need to press down on this lever on the side and just carefully push the filament in, and you will actually be able to see the filament being threaded through. It'll appear almost like fishing line coming out the bottom. When you're finished loading the filament, just press done. Now that you've loaded the filament into the 3D printer, you're ready to level the 3D printer. To do this, just go back to the main menu, click on Tools, select Level, and you'll see the platform will start to move. The 3D printer will walk you through the basic steps for leveling the platform. On the 3D printer, you'll notice some instructions. It's actually asking you to tighten all three nuts that are underneath the platform. We actually ask you to skip this very first step. Just press OK and then confirm yes. You'll see the extruder head will now move into position. It's going to help us go through the leveling process. Follow the instructions that are on the screen. Now the extruder head has moved into position and the sensor will adjust and be reading the distance, and you'll be guided through the process by the instructions on the screen. Here it's asking me to turn the nut underneath because the distance is too big. And I have to turn it until I hear this tune. Press verify, and the sensor will go through the same process again to check if the distance is correct. If the printer is happy with the distance, you'll get a congratulations and you can press OK. And the extruder will now move to the next point to check if the base is level. I've just repeated the same steps as before. You may need to repeat this several times. Now the extruder will move to the final position at the back of the platform. It will repeat the same processes and we will follow the instructions that appear on the screen. Once the leveling process has completed, you'll get a message on the screen saying level complete and you are ready. You press finish. Now that you've loaded your filament and leveled the platform, don't forget to put the protective hood on. I find this is best done by standing from behind, slide over the guider tube, squeezing down at the back first. And you just have to give it a little squeeze at the front and it will click into place like that. Now that we've prepared our 3D printer ready for printing, I have my design already loaded on a USB stick and I can just insert it on the side here, coming around and at the main menu, one of the options is build. Select the USB stick and then scroll down until you can see your file with your design. You'll get a preview on this menu screen and you're going to press build. What you'll see now is the 3D printer will start to heat up and then it will commence your print. This is the time that we recommend that you just keep an eye on your print because this is the time when something may go wrong. Once you know its printing is underway, you can leave it alone. Now that your 3D print has finished printing, you'll open the front, you'll remove the platform, and you'll be able to take your 3D print off the platform.
This video is part of a series of support videos all about the kit that you have borrowed. To find the other videos in this series, head to the Learning Library and visit the kit page for the equipment you've borrowed. You can also find the full list of support videos for all of our kit on the YouTube channel. You can also join us in the Yammer community. If you have any questions or you'd like to ask teachers how they've used the equipment in their classroom, then why not join us on the STEM T4L Facebook community? It's a closed group. You can ask teachers how they've used the equipment and also share the work samples that your students have created.